What's up guys, welcome back once again to the Gaming Careers YouTube channel. Today we're going to be talking about green screens and how you can use a green screen within your stream so you can do cool things. Actually, one sec. Like this. Now obviously I'll throw some other examples of streamers using a green screen and some of the creative ways that they have used them to incorporate some funny or epic moments into their stream. But in this video, we're going to be going through why you'd want to use a green screen for your stream, what equipment you need exactly, and I'm going to be covering different budgets for this. So right from the cheapest way of implementing a green screen up to something more expensive like the Elgato green screen that I've got. We're also going to be talking about how you can use a green screen in OBS and Streamlabs OBS, so exactly how you set it up to chroma key out the background. And finally, I'll be going over some tips and tricks for lighting and exactly how you want to set up your green screen to make sure you get the crispest image. All of that coming up. So obviously the main purpose of having a green screen is to be able to cut your talent out from their background, and then you can overlay that talent on, you know, your game, or maybe it's your desktop or your Twitch chat or whatever you want to do. But the idea is that you can have both your talent and some sort of background in the same shot, composited one above the other. So what you're going to need to be able to achieve this look is obviously a camera of some sort. This can be a webcam, it can be, you know, a camera plugged into an Elgato cam link like mine is, and basically the higher resolution, the more detail you're going to get and the better quality the cut between the talent and the green is going to be. So I would recommend certainly using one of the higher end webcams to achieve really great results. Something like the Logitech C920, which is often recommended. I've been recommending it in my kits for absolutely ages, will do absolutely brilliantly. Or if you have the luxury of being able to use an actual camera, mirrorless or DSLR, plugged into a capture device like the Elgato Cam Link, then that will do even better. In terms of the actual green screen, it's one of those things that's going to be completely dependent on your budget. Here on Amazon, I found three different types of green screen for three different budgets, so hopefully one of these will be perfect for you. At the start, we've got these sort of foldable green or blue screens that they sort of fold up into a circle, similar to some of those pop-up tents that you can get for camping and festivals and things like that. So they pack away nice and small, but when they actually open up, they open up to a decent size. The difficulty with these is that they have to be, you know, hung or placed against the wall or something like that. So these are really great if you have the ability to be able to hang it or to be able to put it against the wall, if that is what your streaming setup is. But they're super cheap and, you know, you can't really go wrong with something like this for $40. Next up, you have the traditional green screen, which is the green material. This one here is nice and large, 9 by 15 feet. Comes with three clips, but you would need to have a place to secure it to. Most of you, I imagine, would have to purchase something like this, sort of a studio rail, which is two light stands with a beam across the top, which you can hoop through the green screen. These are pretty much what a traditional green screen setup is. Something nice and large, does take up quite a bit of room, but can pack down quite quickly unless you're going to leave it up the whole time. But this is traditional, sort of around the $50-$60 when you factor in both the stand as well as the green screen. And then finally we have what I have, which is the new Elgato green screen. Well, I say new, it's probably been out for 6 months or so now. Super handy, super convenient, packs all the way down into its body. Has its own support beams at the back, so you can set it to any height. I've absolutely loved the product, but it is on the pricey side, so I think this is the ideal solution, and there isn't really any competitor for it in terms of how convenient it is and how quickly it packs away and you can set it up. But it is a little bit pricey, so I understand that some people this might be out of budget. The last bit of equipment that you're going to need is some decent lighting. Now, you might not think that lighting is a key aspect in terms of a green screen, but you actually need to be able to light both your talent or your subject, yourself, I would imagine, as well as the green screen separately to make sure that you have that consistent green color, which is going to make it much easier when it comes to chroma keying it out. I've got a couple of examples here on Amazon. The New Air 160, it's a very popular light for filmmakers, gets very, very bright even in such a small panel, or something like the Viltrox panel as well. There's so many of these LED light kits on Amazon. I'm sure you can find one that is large enough for you. But the main purpose, obviously, is to be able to light yourself as well as your green screen independently. So you might need to pick up a couple of these kits. A couple of tips to do with the actual lighting. The further away the green screen is from the talent, so the bigger the distance between the talent and the green screen, the less harsh the shadows are going to be. So if you're stood right next to your green screen, like you may have to be, you're going to get harsher shadows, and in that case you probably are going to want to light the green screen separately with a second light source. Before we jump into OBS and Streamlabs OBS, one tip would be that you don't want the green screen to be too narrow when surrounding your talent or yourself. You want to have some leeway so that the person on screen can, you know, raise their hands and things like that without their hands being cut off because of the narrow green screen. The second thing worth mentioning is that keying out in OBS or any of these programs is actually quite CPU intensive. So if you are struggling to keep frame rates and not drop frames anyway, you might consider maybe just having a normal webcam without any keying, because it is a CPU intensive task. Your computer is having to do all the processing of removing that background information. So just bear that in mind if you're having any issues. Okay, so here we are in OBS, and the first thing that we want to do probably is just to play around with the cropping of our webcam to make sure that it's completely surrounded by green. I've just got an example scene set up here with a picture of Fortnite, just as if I was playing it, and my webcam camera in the bottom corner. So the first thing we want to do is crop the webcam to make sure that we are completely surrounded by green, and this section just here where you can see some of my background shelving unit isn't shown. So to do that, you can hold down the Alt key and drag in any of the areas that you want to crop out. So I'm just going to drag in the sides a little bit so they're surrounded by green, and the top by just a touch. And there we go. Now I am completely surrounded by green. Background isn't completely the same color, but it's a pretty good attempt. So next we're going to be looking at removing this green background so that I can sit just on top of the game layer. To do that, we want to come down to the camera source here, or your webcam source, right click and go to filters. Now you can see in the effect filters list, we do actually have the LUT that we set up a couple of weeks ago. So if you haven't yet watched that video of how to add filters and LUTs to your webcam to, you know, change the look and make them look a little bit more cinematic, do go and check out that video. I'll link it up in the top card, but we're just going to have that disabled for now. And we're going to come and add a new effect filter by clicking the plus icon and selecting chroma key. Obviously, you can name this whatever you want. Chroma key works for me, so I'm just going to leave it at its default and click OK. Now you can see as soon as I click OK, OBS has applied its default settings, which is a green chroma key. And you can see it's done a pretty decent job, really. If you look down in the bottom corner where it's already been cropped, it's not bad. There's a little bit of green on my shoulders and in my hair. Obviously, blonde hair and light colored t-shirts aren't ideal to wear for this, but I thought I would challenge myself and get the settings perfect for you guys. So first option that we have is this key color type, and you have the choice between green, blue, magenta, as well as a custom color. This is just the color of the screen behind you that you're wanting to remove. So the most typical ones are green and blue. Obviously they've got the option of a magenta, or by keying in your custom color, if you know exactly what it is, or you can use the color picker. I've actually found that for the Elgato green screen that I'm using, the green one seems to work the best. So I'm going to leave it at green and then move on to the other options. Similarity is on a scale of 1 to 1000. So if you drag this left and right, you can see it's choosing how similar of a color to the green that they've got set you want to remove. So if I lower this, you can see that some of the darker areas in the bottom corners of my green screen are still showing. So you want to get this to the point where all the green screen is removed, but you know, none of your t-shirt or your body or your face. So around 400 seems to work quite well for me. Next we have smoothness, and this is how smooth of the keying effect will be. So again, you don't want to be removing any of your t-shirt or your hair by going too high, so somewhere around 100 seems to work quite well for me, but this will be completely dependent on your setup and your lighting and all those kind of things, your camera. Key color spill reduction, this is just trying to reduce the amount of spill that might appear on the shoulders or in the hair. If you have blonde hair, it's a little bit more difficult. So you're just trying to remove that spill of green from those areas. And that looks pretty decent actually there. Finally, you have some options for opacity, contrast, brightness, gamma, those kind of things. I'm gonna leave these all as default, but do feel free to play around if you need to. And then if we can just click close, and you can see that has now applied my green screen effect, and you can see how clear that is. If I hold my hand up especially, you can see straight through my fingers onto the green screen. There is still a little bit of green color in my hair, so I would probably go back into the settings and just make sure that I'm fine tuning to make sure that that is removed. But bearing in mind that I haven't set up any sort of lights just specifically for the background here, and I've tried to make it as challenging as possible by wearing a light t-shirt and obviously having blonde hair, I think that looks pretty decent. I'm just going to go back in and just play a tiny bit just to try and remove that green from my hair. So I should be able to play around with the color spill a little bit and maybe the smoothness as well. And there you go, you can see it's reduced now. And then if you went back to apply your LUT, you can see that even looks even better. So there I am in the bottom corner of my screen. Obviously, if I put my hands on the outside of where I've cropped my camera, that's going to remove. So I want to try and remain in this frame as much as possible. But there I am in the bottom corner of my Fortnite game example. If Streamlabs OBS is your streaming software of choice, the process is exactly the same as it's part of that core OBS functionality that was originally moved across into Streamlabs OBS. So all you have to do is find your webcam or your camera source, right click, filters, find the color key, and make sure you dial in the settings to be able to remove your background without removing any of your subject. Another really important point is that you want your subject not to be wearing any of the color that your background is. So if your background is green, avoid wearing any green, as that will also be removed. So if you have a green logo on your t-shirt or something like that, that's obviously also going to be removed. Another bonus tip for OBS and Streamlabs OBS is it's not just video capture devices that you can apply the color keying to. You could also do it to video. So if you find some videos on the internet that have a green screen, you can also apply the color key in OBS or Streamlabs OBS to a video. One last thing I will mention is if you are using a webcam that has sort of some drivers installed and does things with auto white balance, you're probably going to want to jump into those options and disable it. Because when auto white balance is enabled, sometimes it's going to mess up what the green looks like. And obviously OBS is looking for a specific color of green to remove from the keying. So if it's going to keep changing white balance because of this auto white balance setting within the webcam, that's going to mess it up. So make sure you disable that. The last thing that I will mention is just to raise the question, do you actually want to remove your background from your live stream? A lot of people find that having a background with, you know, some things on shelving units, I know I don't have anything interesting on there yet, but over time I'd like to think that I'm going to build up, you know, parts of my personality and have them on this shelving unit. So maybe a green screen isn't right for you, but if it is, I hope you found this video useful. If you have, please do give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. As always, a massive thanks to the patrons this month who have helped fund the creation of these videos. Do check out my Patreon page if you haven't already. And subscribers, I will see you in the next video. Peace.